Welcome back everyone. In today's video, we will dive into the fascinating world of JSON, also known as JavaScript Object Notation. JSON is widely used for data interchanging, especially in web APIs. By the end of this video, you will have a solid understanding of JSON's syntax, data structures, and how to work with it using JavaScript. So let's get started. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It is a lightweight data format that is easy for humans to read and write and easy for machines to parse and generate. JSON is often used to exchange data between a server and a web application, making it an essential skill for any budding web developer. Syntax and data structures of JSON. JSON has a simple and intuitive syntax. It consists of key-value pairs enclosed in a curly braces. Each key is followed by a colon and its corresponding value. Key-value pairs are separated by commas. The values can be of different types such as strings, numbers, booleans, arrays, or even nested objects. Let's take a look at an example. Imagine we have an object representing a person's information. We can define it in JSON like this. Creating and working with JSON objects and array in JavaScript. Now that we understand the syntax and structure of JSON, let's see how we can create and work with JSON objects and arrays in JavaScript. JavaScript provides built-in methods to handle JSON. In JavaScript, we can create a JSON object using curly braces and assign values to its properties. We can then access these properties using dot notation or square brackets. Similarly, we can create JSON arrays using square brackets and access their elements using indexes. Serializing JavaScript objects to JSON. Now, what if we have a JavaScript object and want to convert it to a JSON string? That's where serialization comes into play. JSON.stringify is a powerful method in JavaScript that allows us to convert JavaScript objects into JSON strings. Let me show you an example. As you can see, the JavaScript object has been successfully converted to a JSON string using JSON.stringify. This can be useful when sending data to a server or storing data locally. Parsing JSON data into JavaScript objects. When working with JSON, it is common to receive JSON data from an API or retrieve it from a file. To use the data in JavaScript, we need to parse it into JavaScript objects. The JSON.parse method comes to our rescue. Let's take a look at an example. Suppose we have a JSON string representing a person's information. We can use JSON.parse to convert it into JavaScript object. As you can see, we successfully parsed the JSON string into a JavaScript object using json.parse. Now we can easily access and manipulate the data within it. Accessing and manipulating data in JSON objects and arrays. Once we have our JSON data in the form of a JavaScript object, we can access and manipulate the data within it, just like we do with any other JavaScript object or array. Let's continue with our person object from the previous example. As you can see, we accessed the name property of the person object, modified the age property, and added a hobbies property with an array value. Manipulating JSON data is just like working with any other JavaScript object or array. Working with nested JSON structures. JSON allows us to represent complex data structures using nested objects and arrays. Understanding how to work with nested JSON structures is crucial when dealing with more intricate data. Let's consider an example where we have a JSON object representing a user profile with nested address details. Here we have accessed the city property within the nested address objects using dot notation. Remember, you can access nested properties in JSON objects using dot notation or square brackets, just like we saw earlier. Error handling when working with JSON data. When working with JSON data, it is essential to handle errors that may occur, such as invalid JSON syntax or unexpected data structures. JavaScript provides error handling mechanism to ensure our code is robust. Let's see an example of error handling when parsing JSON data. In this example, we intentionally created an invalid JSON string with a missing closing quotation mark for the age property. When we attempt to parse it using json.parse, an error occurs. We can catch the error using a try-catch block and handle it gracefully. Error handling ensures that even working with imperfect or unexpected JSON data, our code can gracefully recover and continue executing. That concludes our exploration of handling JSON data. We covered how to parse JSON into JavaScript objects, access and manipulate data within JSON objects and arrays, work with nested JSON structures, and handle errors that may arise. Remember to practice these concepts on your own, follow along with the examples, and experiment with JSON data. The more you practice, the more comfortable you will become in working with JSON. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more exciting JavaScript tutorials. Stay curious and keep coding.